Coming up on today's episode of Airborne Unlimited, Fisher Flying Products is alive and well, introducing new Aria. Also, Volga-Dnepr Airlines suspends AN-124-100 and -150 commercial operations, and holiday drone shows coming to select cities. Thank you for joining us this Monday. We hoped you had a great weekend. I'm your host, Kimberly Kay. We have an exciting episode filled with the latest news. So let's start with Fisher Flying Products is alive and well, introducing new Aria. The company is readying an all-new aircraft design, a small low-wing tandem speedster. The aircraft is an all-wood design with composite cowl and bubble canopy. It seats two tandem and has retractable tricycle landing gear. FFP will be offering this aircraft as a full kit with all the metal and hardware components already prefabricated and ready for assembly. They will also be providing an all-premium wood, plywood materials in a kit as well as adhesives.
Based on what we've seen so far, we agree that the bird looks somewhat like a small Tucano.
Using classic wooden construction, the Fisher Aria is entirely boxed with finished birch plywood, except for the control surfaces. This aircraft was designed to comply with the design rules of Aeronautical Standards FAR 23 Part 2 Appendix A. The aircraft is meant to be powered by either a Rodax 912 or a new electric power plant system under development.
Max cruise speed of 186.4 miles per hour, climbing nearly 1,000 feet per minute. The Aria has an 800 statute mile range and can land in under 500 feet.
After the break, dozens of organizations urging for congressional support. I'll explain why after the break.
There's a difference between charting a steady course and pushing for the ceiling. And for nearly a century, Hartzell Propeller has been defining that difference. It's in our passion for engineering and research and our dedication to testing the limits of performance. We are built on honor. We are Hartzell Propeller.
Skyleader Aircraft offers a lineup of the most powerful, durable, and efficient light sport aircraft in the industry. From trainers to roomy cockpits for long hauls, Skyleader has an aircraft for you. And the best part? They're in your budget. Skyleader's base prices are set low to give you room to customize your aircraft to your needs, desires, and wallet, allowing you to put your money where it matters to you most. Visit flyskyleader.com today to learn about our aircraft, customization options, and chat with the team.
BLT is just another tick on your pre-flight checklist until you need it. Did you ever wonder what would happen if you had an engine failure over the mountains, marshland, or other dangerous terrain? Take to the skies confidently with the most reliable and highest performing ELTs and safety products on board that instantly mobilize life-saving search and rescue across the world. Read survivor stories from aviators and adventurers who survived life-threatening encounters thanks to ACR and Artec's life-saving technology. Luck favors the prepared at survivorclub.com.
Welcome back. With so much news coming out of the aviation industry, we're going to be summarizing some other interesting stories in this brief segment we call Around the Patch. So let's start with Texas Aircraft Intro Entry-Level Colt S-LSA. Texas Aircraft Manufacturing is now offering a new generation entry-level Colt S-LSA with G3X touch flight display for almost $140,000. According to Texas Aircraft Manufacturing CEO Mateos Grand, as we now come out from under COVID-19-induced flight training restrictions, the operators of several flight schools have come to us asking for an affordable-priced all-metal, Garmin-equipped training aircraft. He goes on to say, our solution is the highly advanced and very affordable entry-level Colt S-LSA, which is priced at almost $140,000, below the cost of the fully equipped Colt S and Colt S-LSA. EAA joins aviation groups in addressing court regarding Warbird case. EAA has joined the NAFI, ICAS, the North American Trainers Association, GAMA, and others in filing a friend of the court brief in the case of Warbird Adventures Incorporated, et al. Versus FAA. The case is challenging a cease and desist order issued to Warbird Adventures by FAA, in which the FAA alleges that the company is operating a limited category aircraft for composite flight training without a required exemption. The limited category was established shortly after World War II to accommodate surplus military aircraft that otherwise did not have a type certificate. AEA urges protection of satellite comm services from harmful interference. AEA has joined more than 50 other organizations to urge congressional support of several provisions that will protect our nation's military GPS devices and satellite communication services from harmful interference. In a November 20th letter, the coalition wrote, "If the Federal Communications Commission's April 2020 Legato order is left in place, it would append decades of sound spectrum policy, negatively impact a significant cross-section of commercial and federal users who rely on the many different L-band satellite services, and threaten the safety of most Americans." FAI Award Ceremony to take place online on December 2nd. The traditional FAI Award Ceremony has been moved online and converted into an awards announcement due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The event will be broadcasted on Wednesday, December 2nd on the FAI General Conference event website. This year, 45 awardees will be honored with FAI diplomas or medals for their outstanding contributions spanning the wide varieties of the activities, sports, and disciplines within FAI. Well, that does it for today's trip around the patch. Now let's return to the rest of the news. Volga-Dnepr Airlines suspends AN-124-100 and -150 commercial operations. Volga-Dnepr Airlines has announced the temporary suspension of its AN-124-100 and -150 commercial operations as of November 25th of this year until the investigation completion and identification of causes of aviation incident that occurred in Tolmachevo Airport, Novosibirsk, on the 13th of November 2020, soon after takeoff. The airplane suffered the uncontained engine fan disk failure, which resulted in engine failure and the loss of control systems. Carrying 84 tons of cargo with full fuel tanks, suffering engine failure and loss of control elements, the crew managed to avert the disaster, make a 180-degree land, and keep the plane on the runway, skidding off the runway. Following the incident, the Federal Agency for Air Transport has set up a commission, including Volga-Dnepr specialists who are identifying the causes. Volga-Dnepr acknowledges understanding from its customers and partners and takes all the actions to fulfill contractual obligations and resume safe commercial operations. After these messages, to help cheer you up during the holidays, one company is going to use drones to light up the sky.
To celebrate the holiday season, you'll receive 20% off any King Schools course from right now through December 4th. It's our last sale of the year. To get 20% off any King Schools course, go to kingschools.com and choose your courses. You can order online or call one of our customer service pilots at our 800 number and use the code STUFFING. It's that easy.
Hi, my name is Rick Volker. I flew my 600 horsepower North American Harvard in several air shows in North America using Swift UL94. I placed Swift UL94 in one wing tank, 100 low lead in the other wing tank. There was no measurable or perceivable difference in any performance parameter when switching between the two fuels. As a bonus, Swift UL94 prevented any plug fouling. I highly recommend this fuel to keep your aircraft clean and performing well.
I believe that if people use the Landing Doctor Training Program, they will have less accidents and eventually their insurance will go down and they will make a superior pilot. We do personal limitation checklists, which is the most important reason you need to fly with limits. We do ground proximity awareness training, and we do this with a crosswind. We've been operating 6 Purcells for 2 years without one insurance claim. The Landing Doctor program is working, and you're gonna hear more about it.
Welcome back. Here's some good news to start the holiday season. Walmart to produce holiday drone shows. Walmart is planning the Walmart Holiday Drone Light Show in an all-new experience that will be performed in the skies of select communities across the country and via live stream events. The Walmart Holiday Drone Light Show is a free and contactless experience that brings holiday songs to life like never before. Thanks to nearly 1,000 Intel drones launched into the night sky, the light show creates three-dimensional seasonal shapes and characters like snowflakes, reindeers, and snowmen. choreographed to a soundtrack of classic and modern-day holiday favorites, from Frosty the Snowman by Bing Crosby to Run, Run, Rudolph by Kelly Clarkson. 8 communities across the country will be able to experience the modern light show live when it flies through their town. The event promises a fun and safe family night out, complete with pre-show entertainment, including music from local DJs, and a short holiday special. DreamWorks Trolls Holiday, before the drones take flight from December 4th until the 20th. That does it for our show today. Thank you for joining us. I'm your host, Kimberly Kay. Don't forget to subscribe to us on YouTube and check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and on Twitter. Remember, the Airborne Unlimited is currently operating on our winter schedule and is streamed Monday and Friday. You can also catch us on Roku and Fire TV. Just search for Aero-News or Airborne in the directory. We hope you enjoy the show. We'll see you next time.